Give them a call today.
He's up late to give you the news you can't get anywhere else early. He fights for truth and justice in the American way. Please welcome our pal from the Paragon Trust Company, the real Tony D, Tony D'Angelo.
All right, nobody I would like to have on more right now than this next gentleman. Of course, he's been with us for years and years and years now. I said three, at least three, maybe. Maybe we're closing in on five. I always forget. I have so much fog in my brain. But here's the bottom line. Tony D'Angelo joins us at 7:05 each and every Tuesday, and he breaks down a wide variety of topics. Sometimes they're topics that you guys send to him, and he grabs them and he runs with them. And, of course, you can find him on the X, Tony D'Angelo 7, or up, of course, on YouTube. Tony, good election day morning to you. How are you?
And good election day morning to you, Lee Elci, and to all our friends. And once again, I am proud to be among you.
All right. So we have very specific things to chat about today. I want to ask you right away, what happens if Trump loses?
Okay. Grab yourself a stiff drink of coffee, everyone. Now, let's look at a little bit of a pre-post-mortem. Now, go back all the way to those useless debates at the top of the year. Everybody crying on the stage, DeSantis, Haley. We did find out about Ramaswamy. We did find out about Doug Burgum. That was good. But all it really did was didn't help anyone. And then, of course, we had our grand performance by Mr. George Washington Bridge himself, Chris Christie, who created a big splash in the Hudson River. Now, they all should have thought better. They all should have looked down the road and say, what is this going to be? Nikki Haley, perhaps the biggest joke, who comes out with praises of Trump, she was running around screaming that she was going to be the next woman president. I mean, they do these things, and they don't think anybody has any memory of what they did. Oh, that was before, and everybody's guilty of it. And, you know, Donald Trump himself, President Trump, didn't help himself with the Ron DeSanctimonious stuff and the traitorous. And, you know, we chuckled and things like that. Oh, that's Donald. But it wasn't constructive. And, so that would have been, we would have had a missed opportunity there if you were a Republican. Now, if Trump loses, you can't hold Donald Trump entirely blameless. And I've said this for all the years I've been privileged to be here. Donald Trump's worst thing is management. You kind of get the impression some days that the White House kind of runs like an episode of The Apprentice. And I could only hope that, which I think he will do in term two, assuming arguendo he gets there, he's going to rely less on his kids and more on the people like Kennedy and Ramaswamy and Musk. You know, and that would be, I think he's learned that lesson, but, that's just one thing as far as they're like this whole Puerto Rican joke thing with the comic. I mean, number one, how'd the guy get there? And number two, they actually fueled it by giving the whole stupid joke thing credibility. I mean, that's the kind of nonsense that's been the Achilles heel. And if Trump loses, a lot of blame's got to go to the Republican National Committee and the RNC, who took years to finally say, alas, there is voter fraud. And now they're doing it because they're splashing around in the kiddie pool, maybe too little, too late. Lee Elci, I wholeheartedly agree with you. There should be zero tolerance. I mean, zero tolerance for any kind of voter fraud. I mean, are you ever going to get zero tolerance? Of course not, but you're going to get closer. I mean, yesterday, the discussion was a 10% margin of error. 10% is big. Think you're playing baseball. Think one inch to one foul line as opposed to, being in fair territory. If Trump loses, a lot of the blame goes through state Republican parties in New England, Connecticut, who really didn't kind of pretended he wasn't there for a while and now are embracing him. You still have some rockheads that are like, I don't want to see him. And I mean, to our GOP's credit, yeah, there is a statement now that, we This party agrees with Donald Trump, but I mean, we're like way late in the game. And this is the whole thing with, you know, quote unquote, those people wanting 1996 George Bush Republicanism. Guess what? We're never going to get it back. It ain't there. I mean, and when will the light go on? Perhaps this election will do it. That you can't run to be liked if you're a Republican. You have to run to win. You have to run to win. I mean, it's like you're playing as a gentleman. They're ruthless. They'll do whatever they possibly can to lie to your face and go do something else. Now, if you look at all this, and this is the whole thing. This group of people, and I'm not just picking on people here, but I'm picking on whatever you want to call it. Namby-pamby Republicans throughout the country. You're going to help us. You know, you would have helped this whole thing that we're going to see in a Harris presidency of high fuel costs, wind power, national marijuana, curtailment of the First, Second, and Fourth Amendments, racial equity, social media moderation, censorship, boys and girls sports, sex change operations, and it's because you didn't see the big picture. So, That's my post-mortem, pre-mortem. Okay, let's move along because I realize we're short a couple of minutes. If Trump wins, okay, this and I'm sorry to say this, but I was playing this through last night. What are you going to see? You're not going to see this glorious thing of an angel landing on the Empire State Building. And it's so sad if you're believing that, but I want to condition to you to what I believe is going to happen. You're going to see riots. You're going to see meltdowns. You're going to see civil unrest. You're going to look for pre-way protests. Be very careful. You're going to see pro-Palestine protesters off of the wall, people acting out their mental illnesses. You're going to see supply chain clogs. And what's going to happen in the cities? Now, here we got a big public safety issue. Who is going to act? Who will be the adult in the room? Now, Cammy is going to be sitting there crying and election fraud and how can this happen? She will be effectively useless. Basically, she's been useless for the past 4 years. Is pudding brain Joe Biden going to sit there and actually, you know, let's call the National Guard into the cities. Let's make, you know, America comes first. I mean, I'm not terribly hopeful. Now, if Trump wins, let's just say, you know, we're looking at red after red after red, and it's a virtual victory tonight. Cammy's not going to concede. She's going to leave an open door, and she's going to pout, and it's just, you know, this can't be happening. So what happens? Let's look at the series. Let's look at the gauntlet. If Trump wins, Juan Merchan in New York on the fraud trial, on the whatever you want to call it, the civil fraud, advanced to criminal fraud trial, he's got a sentencing date on November 26th. He's going to hear the motion on November 12th about the overturning of the verdict. I'm not terribly hopeful of that. So what will he do? Well, listen, he can convict Donald Trump because Cammy hasn't conceded. So what does that mean? He's going to jam Trump up, or Trump will be jammed up. He'll be in the apartment, or worse, he'll be in Rikers Island. And, you know, it's this all can happen. And this is all going to happen right around Thanksgiving. Family's going to get together. You know, it's going to be I can't fathom what can happen. Now, if Trump wins, look for every administrative state bureaucrat. You know, everybody in every federal agency is going to be writing the regulations that we're all going to have to live with that honestly, truthfully, would be out of a horror movie, because this might be their last chance at the big city. We're going to be paying that for years. Now, think of the border. Everybody on 4, move it out, guys. This may be our last chance. And again, these people are ruthless and they'll stop at nothing, and they really think they're doing God's will. If Trump wins, look for a frantic acceleration of that Jack Smith trial. And, you know, the judge was on yesterday debating the merits of it. Yeah, there are things, and. But look for it, and I don't mean to trivialize that at all, but, you know, anything to call Donald Trump an insurrectionist. So now we go to the White House, right? The best part, Lee Elci, about January 6, 2025, it'll make us forget entirely January 6, 2021. If Trump wins, enter Jamie Raskin, the weasel. He's going to start challenging Donald Trump's ability to be president, and especially if he's got that I card, if he's got that insurrectionist card. And whatever the composition of the Congress will be at that point, I mean, no telling what happens. That's the whole 14th Amendment thing. What's the balance of power? Who decides it? Assuming Donald Trump survives all of that, we go to January 15, 2025. You know what's going to happen then? The Teamsters are going to strike. And it was very curious to me how the, how could I put it, that strike settled in a hurry. So I don't know, at least was delayed for a hurry. What was told, what was said, whatever the case may be, but basically, now here's Trump. He's jammed up in his apartment, or worse, in prison. He doesn't have the, the normal progression of a president-elect to actually start putting the groundwork in place. You know, hey, Mr. President, you know, it's welcome to the office, and then we're going to see the inauguration. So that's getting to the presidency. We'll have a few minutes of what happens in the presidency, but I'd like to paint a rosier picture. Lee Elci, I can't.
Yeah.
I just can't.
Yeah, no matter what happens today, it is, like you had said, it is not going to be a seamless transition. It is not going to be a walk through the garden. It's not going to be, like you had said, landing on top of the Empire State Building like a super savior slash angel. It's going to get ugly. It's going to get messy, I think, no matter what happens.
In a hurry.
Yeah.
In a hurry. So let's look at the administration.
Yeah.
And I realize we're pushing against
time. You got time.
If Trump wins, expect a divided House and Senate. I don't see this as being a clean sweep. One will come up, one will come down. It kind of looks like he'll get the Senate, but the House looks like it'll push against him. That's a problem. You know, they've got the funding. You know, they can send out money for goofy projects, and it's that can be an issue, and would be an issue if so. So what we're going to see is we're not going to see any significant laws passed. The 2017 tax cuts are going to expire. Thank you, weak Republicans. We're all going to be paying a lot more taxes because of the fact that you didn't see this, and I was screaming about it, and others were screaming about it. Again, it's the big picture. We're going to see the monthly clown show with impeachments, and we're going to see that whole parade of things. We're going to see committee action after committee action. We're going to see Nancy Pelosi on steroids. Do not underestimate that woman's evil. You're going to see a full court press like you haven't seen. You're going to see these horrible committee hearings. The worst thing, the thing that really would be bad, which is bad for America, these good people, Musk, Ramaswamy, Kennedy, they're going to be hamstrung. You know, it'll be the same thing that happened with Mnuchin and Lighthizer in the beginning, who had these great plans for reworking things, but Nancy Pelosi jammed them up. But we're going to see good things. We're going to see inflation ceasing. Pipeline will be open. Energy will be sane. A lot of dumb projects won't get there, but it's really going to be a play for the next 2 years. Now, if Kamala Harris wins, get ready for the United States becoming Connecticut and California in the UK. And this is the whole thing, and I've been screaming about this. We're going to be looking at higher fuel, national marijuana, curtailment of the First, Second, and Fourth Amendments, all for our good. We can no longer speak out. We're going to look at higher taxes. We're going to be looking at racial equity, social media moderation, boys and girls sports, and all those things that we discussed. And this is to our Christian friends out there. One of my pastor friends was saying that he saw this as, quote unquote, if Harris wins, it's God's judgment on America. That's scary to me because I've seen things, and I've seen elections, and I've seen things happen. And people haven't grasped the seriousness of what's happening, but we're not going to see, quote unquote, this wonderful America that she paints because she has no foundation for it. And yet, I was saying to somebody last night, if you take a person who's, quote unquote, You make them afraid of Trump, they're mentally weak, and you see this reasonably attractive and intelligent person, or at least an engaging person to a certain degree, talking about a wonderful world and turning the page and all that. You buy into that, but you buy into a lie. And the you're going to see horrific national security. You're going to see Israel sold. You're going to see shameless corruption. You talk about the United States of America becoming Connecticut. You know, you talk about something that Governor Ned Lamont, the unaccountable, is doing. Well, that's going to be on a grand scale, and there's not going to be really any means of pushback. Now, social media, look forward to the United States becoming Britain. Look forward to, you know, Keir Starmer and Elon Musk. Look forward to, you can't say that because that's hurtful. And what the political world loves to do is define what's hurtful. But that, of course, is aligned with their own interests. It is a major slippery slope. What's going to be the standard of the world? Incompetency, incoherency, unaccountability, and taken to steroidal levels. And, you know, and unfortunately, there's plenty of blame to go around. It's going to be one stupid, incoherent mess. And hopefully there'll be some people in pushback in Congress that'll push back against it if it happens. But I'm sitting here on this day, November 5th, 2024, and all I'm thinking of is I wish I could hand the those that desire that it be 1996 or a better world or better democracy I wish I could hand them a better plate. I can. At this point today, be prepared. God save the United States of America.
So I know it's pure speculation on your part. Do you have a prediction that you want to share?
I believe we're going to see that scenario I just described. Trump by a hair, split houses, and the whole lawfare machine is going to come and try to knock him off the track. No one will have the best interests of the country in mind, other than the people who have been elected, but who will be limited in what they can do.
So no matter who wins, America gets run over.
Well, I think there is a large degree of hope if Trump wins and he can hang things together for 2 years, and then in the congressional elections in 2026, more ground is gained. But you're going to see a lot of, a lot of mating in elephants for 2 years. And that's okay. The Republic is safe. It could be a whole lot better and could have been a whole lot better. But I'm not expecting this. Believe me, I would love to come on and say I was wrong and I would thank God for it, but I'm certainly not expecting it.
All right. You around tonight? Are you awake?
Yeah. You can find me here. I mean, you usually find me here.
Well, I'll shoot you a text. I'll be here from at least 8 o'clock on. So if you're up and about, maybe we can chat for a little while.
That'll be a lot of fun. Thank you for having me.
Fine. Tony D'Angelo. Tony D'Angelo 7. Did we, by the way, I'm assuming Thursday on your YouTube will be election related. That's my
guess. We're going to see what develops, and we will take it as it comes. We're going to be as close to the minute as we can get.
All right, Tony. You have a good day, buddy. I'll talk to you later on. Appreciate
it
as
always. Thanks, everybody.
All right. We'll be right back. Flax joins us next. Hang on.